Hello friends, now this is the seventh conceptual idea from sequences. It is related to the arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean. So usually if you have two numbers a comma b, then the arithmetic mean of those two numbers a comma b is a plus b by 2, geometric mean is root ab, and harmonic mean is 2 by 1 by a plus 1 by b. Whereas for three numbers a, b, c, arithmetic mean is sum of those numbers by 3. Geometric mean is the, since we have three numbers, cube root of the product ABC, and the harmonic mean is 3 divided by the sum of the reciprocals of those three numbers. Likewise, we will calculate arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean for those n numbers also, right? In each case, arithmetic mean is nothing but sum of the numbers divided by the number of numbers, whereas geometric mean is the nth root of the product, as well as harmonic mean is the number of numbers divided by the sum of the reciprocals of those numbers. Arithmetic mean, geometric mean, as well as harmonic mean, right? Now, see, if you say some a power n plus 1 plus b power n plus 1 divided by a power n plus b power n. If this is the arithmetic mean of a comma b, if this is the arithmetic mean of a comma b, we need to equalize it to a plus b by 2. From there, you will get the value of n as g. And if this is the geometric mean, you will get n value as minus 1 by 2. And if this is the harmonic mean, you will get the n value as minus 1. See, finally, arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean for any number of numbers, right? And see, from this, for two numbers, if a plus b by 2 root a b and 2 by 1 by a plus 1 by b. If you simplify it, you get it as 2ab by a plus b. If you represent this arithmetic mean by a, geometric mean by g and harmonic mean by h, you will get a relation between this a, g and h as g square is equals to ah. Square of the geometric mean is equals to the product of arithmetic mean and harmonic mean for only two numbers, not for many number of numbers. For only two numbers, we have the relation, right? And one more thing is, based for two numbers, if this is the arithmetic mean, geometric mean, and the equation having a comma b as roots is nothing but x square minus of a plus b, which is nothing but 2ax plus the product is g square is equals to 0. X square minus 2ax plus g square is equals to 0 is the equation having roots as a comma b in terms of the arithmetic mean and geometric mean of the roots. Similarly, we are able to frame a cubic equation whose roots are ABC in terms of arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean also, right? So if you have two numbers AB, we will directly find arithmetic mean and geometric mean. Whereas if you have arithmetic mean and geometric mean in your hands, then how to find the values of AB? By knowing the arithmetic mean and geometric mean, the values of numbers AB is given by the rule that A plus or minus root of A square minus G square. This A is the arithmetic mean, G is the geometric mean. Knowing the numbers AB, easy to find the arithmetic mean and geometric mean. Whereas knowing arithmetic mean and geometric mean, then also we are able to get the numbers AB using the rule that A plus R minus root of A square minus this G square. So these are some basic concepts related to the arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean of the given numbers. Just have a look and I will come with the eighth conceptual idea. Now, this is the eighth conceptual idea from sequences. Very important and useful thing for many questions and many examinations. And that thing is the arithmetic mean is greater than or equals to geometric mean is greater than or equals to harmonic mean for given numbers. If you have two numbers in your hands, then arithmetic mean is a plus b by 2 is greater than or equals to geometric mean root ab is greater than or equals to harmonic mean 2 by 1 by a plus 1 by b. Similar conditions are applicable for n numbers also. Arithmetic mean is greater than or equals to nth root of their product is greater than or equals to n by 1 by x1 plus and so on plus 1 by xn. So using this logic, arithmetic mean is greater than or equals to geometric mean, basically using this one, we are able to solve many inequality questions and we are able to prove many inequalities. So seeing this arithmetic mean is greater than or equals to geometric mean, and this everything is applicable if we have the positive numbers a comma b. So this is all possible for positive a comma b. And for example, if for positive number a, a plus 1 by a is always greater or equals to 2. You need to show it. So to show this inequality as true for every positive value of a, you need to apply am greater or equals to gm for the numbers a and 1 by a. If you apply that condition for these two numbers, you get that sum of these two divided by 2 is greater or equals to square root of the product a into 1 by a. This is 1, and if you send 2 that side, you will get the inequality. Like that, to prove an inequality using am greater or equals to gm, you need to apply arithmetic mean and geometric mean for the given numbers. Okay, and whereas the inequality is there here, the equality sign is there here, this equality holds whenever the numbers a and b are equal. If a and b are equal, here this is a plus a by 2, that is a. Here it is root of a into a, that is also a. So this equality holds whenever the numbers a and b are equal. Here also, whenever this equality holds whenever a and 1 by a are equal, those two are equal when a is equals to 1, right? So this is a simple example related to the arithmetic mean greater or equals to geometric mean. Actually, this is a wonderful technique which is very helpful to solve many inequality questions. For example, if you have a question related to this, something like you need to show something root x square plus x plus some tan alpha divided by root x square plus x is greater or equals to something. So if you have this root is the root x square plus x is a positive thing, tan alpha by root x square plus x is also a positive thing if you identify that alpha in the first quadrant. Then if you apply am greater or equals to gm for this inequality, directly the sum of these two numbers is greater or equals to 2 into root of the product, and you get it as 2 root tan alpha. Whereas instead of mentioning that alpha in the first quadrant, if you say it as tan square alpha, which is always positive. So one number and second number, sum of these two numbers divided by 2. I am sending that to this side. Greater or equals to 2 into the product of these two is root of tan square alpha. So which is greater or equals to 2 tan alpha. So this is also another simple example related to this am greater or equals to gm. There are many problems related to this. Okay. And for example, if you apply this am greater or equals to gm technique for the first n natural numbers. If you apply this technique for the first n natural numbers, then sum of those n numbers divided by the number of numbers is greater or equals to the nth root of the product of those n numbers. So sum of the numbers is nothing but n into n plus 1 by 2, and the whole thing is divided by 2 is greater or equals to nth root of the product is n factorial. Here 1 n will get cancelled. Right? Then this is n plus 1 by 2. N plus 1 by 2 is greater or equals to n factorial to the power 1 by n. And if you send that 1 by n this side, what you have in our hands is n plus 1 by 2 to the power n is greater or equals to n factorial. So this is an inequality which can be proved by using am greater or equals to gm for the first n natural numbers. Likewise, if you have any inequality, to prove it, you need to apply am greater or equals to gm for certain number of numbers. Our logic, our technique is is to identify those numbers for which we are going to apply that am greater or equals to gm. So anyway, in our hands we have a wonderful technique, that is am greater or equals to gm, to prove many inequalities. In the next conceptual idea, I am going to do two more problems related to this inequality. Have a look, and I will come with the ninth conceptual idea. Yeah, now this is the ninth conceptual idea, which is also related to the am greater or equals to gm. In this idea, I am going to deal with two different problems. In the first problem, it is given that 2x plus 3y is equals to 7, and you need to find out the maximum value of x cubed y power 4. See, one relation is given in terms of x and y. There are many possibilities for x and y. Instead of all those possibilities, you need to identify one possibility where you will get the maximum value, x maximum value for x cubed into y power 4. So to solve this, I am going to utilize am greater or equals to gm. To utilize am greater or equals to gm, the first thing is we need to identify certain numbers for which we have to apply that am greater or equals to gm. To identify those numbers, in our mind, I have an idea that I have x cube and y power 4. So I need basically 3 x terms and then 4 y terms. But what I have? 2x. So I need to split this 2x into 3 terms. So I am going to consider 2x by 3, 2x by 3, 2x by 3 for 3 times. Why? Because if you add all these things, you will get again 2x. And I need y for 4 times, but I have 3y. So I will take 3y by 4, 3y by 4, 3y by 4, and 3y by 4. If you observe, basically I have 3 terms like 2x by 3, 4 terms like 3y by 4, and if you apply, totally how many terms there are? 7. Now I am going to apply am greater than or equals to gm for these 7 members. So the left side part is arithmetic mean. Arithmetic means sum of all these things. Sum of all these things means sum of these 3 numbers plus sum of these 4 numbers. Sum of these 3 numbers is nothing but 2x plus sum of these 4 numbers is nothing but 3y divided by, I added total 7 numbers divided by 7, which is greater or equals to 7th root of the product of all these numbers. What is the product of all these numbers actually? I am going to multiply all these numbers. 3 numbers are like a 2x by 3 whole cube, and that is 3y by 5 whole to the power 4. Now 2x plus 3y is actually given as 7. So this is 7 by 7 is 1. This side part is 1. Whereas coming to this side, I have here 2 cube, and here it is 3 power 4 by 3 cube. So I need to simplify it. So this is greater equals to 7th root of, how can I simplify, this is 2 cube by 3 cube, 3 power 4 by 4 power 4 is nothing but 2 square, and then 2 power 8 into x cube y power 4. And if you try to simplify, 1 3 I will get, and then 1 5 I will get. And if you send this 7th root of 3 by what it is, 2 power 5, which is 32, this side, and you will get it as 7th root of 32 by 3 is greater than equals to, it is not actually 7th root. If you send that 7th root this side, you will get it as 1. So in our hands I have that 1 greater than or equals to 3 by 32 x cube y power 4. If you send that 3 by 32 this side, 32 by 3 is greater than or equals to x cube y power 4, and x cube y power 4 is less than or equals to 32 by 3. Since the value x cube y power 4 is always less than or equals to 32 by 3, the maximum value for that x cube y power 4 is 32 by 3. Just have a look here. Okay, I already told you, you need to utilize these videos as a reason for your preparation. So I am taking less time for the explanation. So, given problem is 2x plus 3y is 7, I need to find the maximum value for x cube by power 4. So, I need 3x terms and 4y terms. So, I splitted this 2x as 2x by 3, 2x by 3, 2x by 3, and 3y as like this. Now, there are 7 terms, and we have to apply am greater than or equals to gm for this 7 terms. Left side, it is sum of all these 7 terms by 7. Right side, this is the 7th root of the product of all these things. So, sum is 2x plus 3y, which is also given as 7. 7 by 7 is 1. Whereas on the right hand side, 7th root of the product, I wrote in the product here, 2 cube, 3 cube, 3 power 4, 4 power 4, and x cube by power 4. This simplification is 3 by 32. If you send the 7th root this side, since it is 1, again it is 1. So 1 greater than or equals to 3 by 32 x cube by power 4. On simplification, you have the maximum value as 32 by 3. So this is the first problem. Whereas coming to the second problem, it is given that x square y cube as 6, and I need to find the minimum value for 3x plus 4y. Similar problem, where in the first problem, summation is given and asked for the maximum value for the product. Here the product is given and asked for the minimum value for the summation. Again here, 2x terms and 3y terms are involved. So I need to split the 3x as 2 terms, 3x by 2, 3x by 2, and 4y as 3 terms, 4y by 3, 4y by 3. And 4 by 3. If you look, totally there are 5 terms, and I am going to apply am greater than equals to gm for these 5 terms. Left side, sum of all these 5 terms divided by 5. If you add everything, sum of these 2 is again 3x, sum of these 3 is again 4y divided by 5. Greater than or equals to 5th root of the product of all these numbers. Product of all these numbers means 3 square by 2 square into x square into 4 cube by 3 cube into 5 cube. And if you look, 3 square, 3 cube, you will have 1 3. 2 square, 4 cube,
and we'll have 2 4s, 16 by 3. Already it is given that x square y cube as 6. So this is rather equals to 5th root of 16 by 3 into x square y cube is 6. So 3 2s. 16 2s is 32. 5th root of 32 is 2. So this 3x plus 4y by 5 is rather equals to 2. If you set 5 that side, you have that 3x plus 4y is greater than or equals to 10. That means the value of 3x plus 4y is always greater than 10 or equals to 10. So its minimum value is 10. So this is another problem related to the AM greater than or equals to G. Have a look and I will come with the last conceptual idea. That was 10th conceptual idea from sequences. Now the 10th conceptual idea is the insertion of arithmetic means and the geometric means between the numbers. Basically, if I have two numbers a comma b and I need to insert certain numbers in between these a comma b to form an arithmetic progression or geometric progression. That in the sense, for example, if I inserted some n numbers like x1, x2, x3 and so on, xn in between a and b. After insertion of these n numbers, total there are n and then 2, n plus 2 numbers, if all those will form an arithmetic progression, then these n numbers are mentioned as arithmetic means between a comma b, right? These n numbers are called arithmetic means between a comma b if all these n plus 2 numbers form an arithmetic progression. In such a case, the common difference of this arithmetic progression is given by the rule that b minus a by n plus 1. And one more thing which is derived from this is, if you add all these n arithmetic means, that in the sense x1 plus, x2 plus, x3 plus and so on plus xn, sum of n arithmetic means is directly equals to the n times of the single arithmetic mean of a comma b. Okay, once again, just observe it. See, there are n numbers in between a comma b such that total n plus 2 numbers are forming an arithmetic progression. In such a case, these n numbers are called arithmetic means between a and b. If there are n arithmetic means between a and b by forming an AP whose common difference is b minus a by n plus 1. One more observation is, sum of all these numbers is n times the single arithmetic mean of a and b, right? And another thing is, if these n numbers, if after insertion of those n numbers in between a and b, if those n plus 2 numbers by insertion of those n numbers, if they form a geometric progression, then these n numbers between a comma b are called geometric means between a b. See, if you have a geometric means between a b by forming a geometric progression, then the common ratio of this geometric progression is given by the rule that b by a to the power 1 by n plus 1. The direct way, the direct formula to find the common ratio after insertion of n geometric means between a and b is b by a to the power 1 by n plus 1. And one more observation is, whereas in the arithmetic progression, we added all these numbers. But for a geometric progression, you need to multiply all those geometric means. If you multiply all those geometric means, the product of those n geometric means is the, the product of these geometric means is the nth power of the single geometric mean between a and b. Single geometric mean between a and b is root ab to the power n. So this is one more observation. So this is the 10th conceptual idea. Insertion of n geometric means as well as n arithmetic means between a and b. Whereas in those cases, the direct formula for the common difference for arithmetic progression, common ratio for the geometric progression. So these are the 10th conceptual ideas from sequences. I hope these are very helpful for your preparation regarding mains examination. Thank you.